who the Etruscans were, and where they came from. DNA research has finally solved the long-debated mystery of the Etruscan origins. The Etruscans, a civilization steeped in enigma, their language, their customs, their very origin shrouded in the mists of time. For centuries, historians and archaeologists have debated where this remarkable people came from. But now, thanks to cutting-edge DNA science, we finally have the answer. Let's start by exploring some of their key characteristics. The Etruscans were a powerful and mysterious people who dominated central Italy for over 800 years, from around 900 BCE until the rise of Rome. These formidable people constructed magnificent cities, crafted marvelous artworks, and extended their influence far and wide. Their brilliance rivaled that of ancient Greece and Rome. These guys were also incredible at metalwork, particularly known for their mastery of iron. This gave them a significant advantage in warfare and trade. They became major players in the Mediterranean, establishing trade routes and influencing cultures from Greece to Carthage. Unlike the Roman Empire, Etruria was not a unified empire. Instead, it was a loose confederation of 12 city-states that shared a common language, culture, and religion. Each city-state had its own government and legal system, and they sometimes waged war on each other, but they also cooperated on matters of mutual interest. One of the most intriguing aspects of the Etruscans is their unique language, utterly distinct from those spoken by their neighbors like the Latins and Celts. Its origins remain shrouded in mystery, with only Raetic and Lemnian identified as possible relatives. Together, these languages form the Tyrrhenian family, standing apart from the dominant Indo-European languages that swept across Europe at the time. While linguists can make educated guesses about pronunciation due to the Etruscan alphabet's resemblance to the Greek one, the language's meaning remains largely elusive. This lack of comprehension casts a veil of enigma over many aspects of Etruscan culture, history, and religion, contributing to their enduring image as a civilization shrouded in mystery. The debate surrounding the Etruscans' origins reaches back to the dawn of historical writing. Ancient Greek historians, like Herodotus, looked for connections across the Mediterranean. They believed the Etruscans migrated to Italy from Anatolia, a region in modern-day Turkey. This theory, known as the Anatolian origin theory, suggested the Etruscans may have been refugees or even invaders. However, Roman historians offered a different perspective. Observing cultural similarities between the Etruscans and earlier inhabitants of Italy, like the Villanovans, they proposed a theory of autochthony, meaning the Etruscans were native to the land. This theory, known as the indigenous origin theory, suggested the Etruscans developed their unique culture from local roots, building upon the foundation laid by the Villanovans. For a long time, these theories were nothing more than speculation. However, recent breakthroughs in genetics have opened a new window into the past. By analyzing DNA extracted from ancient Etruscan remains, scientists can now peer directly into their genetic makeup. The results have been astonishing. Imagine a bar graph. Etruscan DNA shows a mixture of two main ancestral components. About two-thirds of their ancestry originated from local Italian populations of the Copper Age. This population was formed by a mixture of early European farmers and Western hunter-gatherers, and is genetically similar to the famous Iceman Atsi. This finding supports the theory that the Etruscans were indigenous to Italy. The remaining third of their DNA tells a surprising tale. It hints at a connection to the Eurasian steppes, the vast grasslands north of the Black Sea. This steppe ancestry is linked to the spread of Indo-European languages across Europe. This suggests a possible migration or cultural exchange that brought these influences to the Etruscans. But hold on, there's another twist. Despite speaking entirely different languages, the Etruscans and their Latin neighbors shared striking genetic similarities. This tells us that language and genetics don't always go hand in hand. This is particularly evident when examining their Y chromosomal haplogroups, which trace paternal ancestry. Etruscan males carried a predominance of haplogroup R1b, which is typically associated with Indo-Europeans. This is intriguing because the Etruscans themselves spoke a non-Indo-European language. Theories abound regarding how they maintained their unique language. One possibility is that the Etruscans adopted the cultural and linguistic practices of an earlier Italian population while incorporating steppe ancestry. Here's a heat map visualizing the genetic similarity between Etruscans and modern populations. Genetic similarity is represented by color, with darker red indicating higher similarity. As you can see, Central Italians, Northern Italians, Spaniards, and Corsicans share the highest genetic similarity with the Etruscans. By the 1st century BCE, the Etruscans had been assimilated into the Roman Republic through a series of Roman-Etruscan wars. However, their influence continued to shape the course of Roman history. We see Etruscan influence in everything from Roman religion, with its emphasis on elaborate rituals and soothsaying, to architectural styles like the use of arches and vaults. In conclusion, genetic research is rewriting the story of the Etruscans. They were not newcomers from a foreign land, but a complex and vibrant people with deep roots in Italy. Their legacy continues to inspire us today, reminding us of the rich tapestry of cultures that shaped the ancient world.